Good evening. Excuse me, this season. We are combining a couple things tonight, our spring weather being what it is. The choir has worked hard and is excited to share with you their version of this march toward the cross. And tonight is a quiet night where we remember our need for a Savior and the links to which and the intimacy with which Jesus treats those whom he loves. We will come to a table, as is our custom, occasionally. We will share that in a few minutes. We will leave quietly. We will remember that Sunday is coming. But tonight, we begin to remember why we need Resurrection Day. Why we need Good Friday. We acknowledge our need for a Savior, and we acknowledge the perfection of Jesus Christ. And we remember, as he commanded us to do, the meal he shared with those closest to him. And we share that symbol together this evening. So thank you for making your way here. I ask you to be patient tonight with yourselves. It's a Thursday. Friday's coming tomorrow. There are things to do. But for these moments, breathe deeply. Slow down. Just be still. Be presumptuous enough to believe that God can change you in these quiet moments. So we listen to song and we break bread together. At the end of the service, these elements at the front will be taken away. Again, Resurrection Day is coming, but not yet. These elements will be taken away. And when the ministers and a couple others have cleared the sanctuary, that will be your cue to silently, slowly depart. Will you join me in prayer as we ask God to join us? Father, we avoid quiet moments often. Our minds whisper accusingly, doubtfully in those quiet spaces. Invade those places in our mind and in our hearts this night. Remind us in our busyness and our distracted nature, what a precious gift your Son was and is for us. Teach us again to hold tightly to the promise in that gift. Remind us of our need of grace and the lengths to which you go to provide it. Make that real in our hearts this night, Father. Fill this place. Fill the space in us and between us and all around. It's in Christ's name we pray. Amen. You'll find a hymnal in front of you. Turn to hymn number 143. And you can stay in your seat while we sing. Let's worship together.
Lord, torn, draw, slow, is this, O my soul, O my soul. The disciples gathered around Jesus, reclining, as was their custom, at the table to share a meal together, a Passover meal, one that they had experienced many times before, many years before, seasons before. And a Passover meal included teaching, included remembering, including why this is what's being served at the table, and we're sharing together. Two of those elements, two of the items on the table, were the bread and the wine, the cup and the bread. Maundy Thursday means new covenant. New covenant. New commandment to follow from Passover's before to this new day, a new teaching. So Jesus, in speaking with the disciples and sharing the cup and the bread with his disciples, said on this evening, this week of Passover, a new teaching, a new covenant, he said, I give to you to love one another. This new commandment I give to you to love as you have been loved. This city outside of these walls, this world that expands beyond us as we go and tell of the love we have experienced from God, needs to hear the love of God, needs to experience grace. And so as you receive this evening, my friends, disciples, and church today, my friends, as you receive this bread and cup, you receive, Jesus said, me. You receive me. The bread that I break this night represents my body, which is broken for you. This cup that I share with you that is poured out is my blood that will be shed for you for the forgiveness of the sins of the world. We come tonight, Maundy Thursday, with the new teaching of Jesus in our ears and prayerfully permeating our soul, that Jesus comes alive again in us, and we, as we were commanded and taught, do this in remembrance of Jesus. We have communion. We have meal. We have the cup and the bread together in remembrance of Jesus. And this evening, in remembrance of that first experience, the sharing of the Passover meal between Jesus and the disciples in Jerusalem on Passover on the way to Calvary. All of you are invited to come to the table and receive these gifts of God for the children of God, provided for you by Jesus. You see where I'm standing? So if you're this side of where I'm standing, this direction, half of here in this direction, you just, as it comes to your row, then you come to the front, and you'll take a piece of the bread, and you'll dip it in the cup, and while you're standing up here with me, or with Curtis, or choir with Billy Rao, you'll receive it when you stand there, and then you go back to your seat. Please come to the table. There is a gluten station for those that need that right here beside me as well.
Let's pray together as the Lord taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.
Now the feast of unleavened bread, which is called the Passover, drew near. And the chief priests and the scribes were seeking how to put him to death, for they feared the people. Then Jesus said to the chief priests and the captains of the temple and elders, "Have you come out as against a robber with swords and clubs? When I was with you day after day in the temple, you did not lay hands on me. But this is your hour and the power of darkness." Then they seized him and led him away, bringing him into the high priest's house. Now the men who were holding Jesus mocked him and beat him. They also blindfolded him and asked him, "Prophesy, who is it that struck you?" And they spake many other words against him, reviling him. When they came, the assembly of the elders of the people gathered together, both chief priests and scribes. And they led him away from their council, and they said, "If you are the Christ, tell us." But he said to them, "If I tell you, you will not believe, and if I ask you, you will not answer. But from now on, the Son of Man shall be seated at the right hand of the power of God." And they all said, "Are you the Son of God then?" And he said to them, "You say that I am." And they said, "What further testimony do we need? We have heard it ourselves from his own lips."
And the multitude arose, and together they began thus to accuse him.
"This man bringeth about perverting all the nations, and forbidding to render tribute to Caesar.
Saith he is Jesus,
saith he is Jesus,
our
master,
King of Israel,
our master,
King of Israel,
rise, rise, and the Son of
blessed." Then Pilate said to the priests, the elders, and the people,
"In him I find no evil. The man is faultless."
It sounded the people.
"He stirreth up the Jews by teaching them in every place.
He stirreth up the Jews by teaching them in every place.
Near and far,
near and far,
throughout Judea,
throughout Judea,
near and far,
near and far,
throughout Judea,
throughout Judea,
Barabbas to us,
and give Barabbas to us,
and give Barabbas to us,
but still they cried.
Crucify, 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 crucify,
crucify, crucify, crucify, crucify, crucify, crucify, crucify, crucify, crucify,
crucify,
crucify,
crucify,
crucify, crucify, crucify, crucify, crucify, crucify,
Oh,
to love.